Hello all, welcome to my channel Brainy Beardo. This session would be my second video on the topic Fluid Kinematics. Okay, and the topic that we will be discussing here be types of fluid flow. Okay, without giving much of an introduction, because this is a self-explanatory heading. Okay, so without giving much explanation about what this topic is all about, let me just go on to the topics directly. Okay, so here thing that we will be discussing here would be steady and unsteady flow. So let us understand what a steady flow is. A flow where the fluid characteristics like velocity, pressure, density, temperature, so on, so do not change with time. Okay, these values do not change with time. So the such kind of a flow is called as steady flow. Just to understand that, what I would do is I will just give a small diagram here. So this is a control volume, like I explained in the Eulerian method. Let's say some fluid is entering inside this control volume, and I would define something called as a section here. In this section, let's say for example, as time is a major constraint over here, I would define at a particular time, let's say when the fluid flow is started and when the time is around 5 seconds, okay? When the time is around 5 seconds, at this particular section, let us define that the velocity is around 10 meter per second and the density is around 1000 kg per meter cube. This is at this particular section, right? So what happens here is, at this particular section, if I change the time, okay? Now let's say for example, I'm changing the time to around 10 seconds. When I change the time with respect to 10 seconds, when I increase the time to 10 seconds, at this particular section, the velocity is still 10 meter per second, and if the density is still 1000 kg per meter cube, none of these characteristics like pressure, temperature, all these values do not change, which means that kind of a flow is called as steady flow. One more thing you need to understand is, this I am defining only at this particular section. At a different section, at a different point, the velocity might change, but with respect to time, at that particular section, the velocity, temperature, density, whatever it is, should not change. Such kind of a flow is called as steady flow. Okay, now let me just give an example of steady flow. So let us define unsteady flow. A flow where the characteristics, similar thing, where the fluid characteristics like flow, velocity, pressure, density change with time. Okay, one thing please understand here is, time is the major constraint over here, nothing else. Okay, the position is not the constraint here, time is the constraint here. So again, a similar example like this, a similar section where at time t is equal to 5 seconds, the velocity is 10 meter per second and the density is 1000 kg per meter cube. As you can see, if I increase the time to around 10 seconds, okay, if I increase the time to around 10 seconds, at that particular position earlier, which was 10 meter per second and 1000 kg per meter cube, the values would have come down or increase or whatever. I've just taken an example of come down. The value would have changed to, let's say, 5 meter per second, and the density is around 1200 kg per meter cube. So if the values change like this, then the such kind of a flow is called as unsteady flow. Okay, such kind of a flow is called as unsteady flow, right? So this is about steady and unsteady flow. This is about the first category. Now, second category, I would be calling it as, it is defined as uniform and non-uniform flow. Okay, it is defined as uniform and non-uniform flow. So let us understand, the first topic is uniform flow. What is a uniform flow? A uniform flow is a flow where a fluid characteristic, same like velocity, pressure, temperature, density, whatever, do not change with respect to space or position. Do not change with respect to space or position. Now, in the previous case, steady and unsteady flow, we used to take it with respect to time. But here, we are taking it with respect to space. So, which means, just to make you understand this, I'll just take another diagram here, a similar diagram like this. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take two sections over here, okay? Two sections. If I take two sections, and at one section, let me say the velocity is 10 meter per second, and the density is 1000 kg per meter cube. If in the other section, as different sections, I can take not just one section, I can take as many sections I can want. Any other point, if I define, if the velocity is still 10 meter per second and the density is still 1000 kg per meter cube, then such kind of a flow is called as uniform flow. Alright, so that is called as uniform flow. Here, one thing you need to understand is, with respect to positions at different time intervals, the values should be same. Okay, let's say for example, this 10 meter per second and 1000 kg per meter cube, I have defined at 5 seconds. Now let's say at 10 seconds, at the first session, the velocity and density has changed, which means in the second section also, the velocity and the density should change with respect to the first section. So do you guys understand this, right? So which means it is not the same with respect to time. Here we define uniform flow and non-uniform flow with respect to position and not with respect to time, right? Okay, now again, obviously, what a non-uniform flow would be a flow where the characteristics like velocity, temperature, pressure, density change with respect to position or space. Now, for that again, a similar example of two different sections is what I'm going to take here. The velocity is 10 meter per second and the density is 1000 kg per meter cube in the first section. If in the second section, if the velocity and density has changed, at least any one parameter has changed, and such kind of a flow is called as non-uniform flow. Okay, any one parameter could change. Not just every parameter has to change. Any one parameter changes also, it is called as non-uniform flow. Okay. Now, the third kind of fluid flow is described as laminar flow and turbulent flow. Okay, the third one is called as the laminar flow and the turbulent flow. Now, let us describe something called as laminar flow. What exactly is a laminar flow? A flow where the fluid particles move in a well-defined path and the path is straight and parallel. Okay, when I say like this, the fluid particles should move something like in a very disciplined manner. They should go in a well-defined path and they should be very much straight and parallel, and each fluid particle should not interfere with the other fluid particle. So let's say for example, the first fluid particle's path should not just pass over or cross over the second fluid particle's path. Okay, if such kind of a flow is there, it is called as laminar flow. I'll just take a small control volume here again. What I would do is, these are the five different fluid particles' path. Okay, now as you can see is they are perfectly straight and they are perfectly parallel to each other. They are not disturbing. The first value is not disturbing the path of the second one, right? So they just keep moving forward, and if a flow is something like this, it is called as a laminar flow. A simple example is what I can give you is a march past. Now, you guys would have seen in the army, there is something called as the march past, where the soldiers walk in such a way that they're very much disciplined. Every single person, every single soldier walk in a disciplined manner, right? So basically the first layer of soldiers do not cross over the path of the second layer of soldiers, right? So they go in a very straight fashion, pretty much parallel to each other and very disciplined fashion. If all the fluid particles flow in such a way, and then such kind of a flow is called as the laminar flow. Obviously, the second one, such kind of a path is called as turbulent flow. Okay, a very good example about this, a simple example on how this turbulent flow could be given an example as, like, let's say for example, you go to this Bombay railway station, the passenger railway station. There you guys can see people there in the railway station, in the platform, are not disciplined. I'm not saying they're disciplined with their habits or whatever. I'm just saying you there is, they just, whenever a train comes, they just rush in to go into the cabin, right? They don't even look, they don't go in a well-defined straight line or whatever it is. They just push each one another. They just try to block one another. There is a lot of chaos created out there. Similarly, in a turbulent flow, the fluid particles flow in such a way that there is a lot of chaos and there is no well-defined path. So such kind of a flow is called as a turbulent. Now, the next one that I have to define is called as the compressible and incompressible flow. Now, when I say compressible flow, it is a flow. So let us first define compressible flow. A flow where the density of the fluid particles change at point to point, or the density is not constant. So basically, during the fluid flow, the density will never remain constant, rather it just keeps on varying. Okay, if a flow happens in such a way, such kind of a flow is called as compressible flow. So let's say, for example, again, I'm taking a simple example like this. I'm taking two different sections again here. At the first section, again, I'm taking the density to be as 1000 kg per meter cube. If in the second section, the density changes to a different value, say like around 1200 kg per meter cube, then such kind of a flow is called as compressible flow. Okay, this happens mainly because of the change in volume, and basically this happens in gases, and very rare it happens in liquids. Okay, so the second kind is called as the incompressible flow. In the incompressible flow, again, a flow where the density remains constant. Okay, it does not change, it has to remain constant. So such kind of a flow is called as incompressible flow. Again, with the same example, I have taken two different sections. At the first section, the density is 1000 kg per meter cube. And in the second section also, if the density is not changed and it is still at the same value of 1000 kg per meter cube, and such kind of a flow is called as incompressible flow. Okay, so these are the different categories of fluid flows. I'll just repeat once again. It's called steady and unsteady, uniform and non-uniform, laminar and turbulent, compressible and incompressible flow. Apart from this, there are also four other types of flows. I mean, there are a few other types of flows like rotational and irrotational, and one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and three-dimensional flows, which I'm not discussing in this topic right now. Okay, so thank you for your valuable time watching this particular video. If there is any suggestions that you guys want, please put it up in the comment box, right? Thank you so much.